Our family is universal. Our abode is also universal. Harar me pita Gauri mata swadesha bhumanatrayam. The universal father Shiva is our father. The universal mother Gauri is our mother. She is the causal matrix. And this universe is our homeland. We are to pass through different main propensities of human mind without suppressing them. The question of suppression, repression, or say oppression doesn't arise in the realm of spiritual cult. Equipoise, that is, you are to move maintaining proper parallelism with the fundamental propensities of human mind. This cult, the spiritual cult is the only cult. Others are not cults, they are mere dogma. But if the cult is proper, cult in the true spirit of the term, it creates a sort of subtlety or subtleness in mental flows. Under such circumstances, we get necessary help from positive microvita. As a result of this help, the help that we get by dint of our spiritual practice, practice of the cult, are generally 8 in number. This cult, this spiritual specialities are acquired through cult, that's why they are known as occult power. But while acquiring these occult powers, we cannot do anything without the help of positive microvita. They are anima, laghima, mahima, ishitva, bhashitva, prakamya, prapti, and antaryamitya. Anima means converting the psychic existence into a small point and thus transforming the very psychic existence into a minimum entity. Entity means here psychic entity. One may understand anything by becoming one with different waves of expression and emanation by moving according to the wavelengths of those ideas. Unless and until the very psychic existence is converted into a point, one cannot move or dance according to the wavelengths of that particular idea or ideas. This occult power acquired through positive microvita is called anima. And laghima. Laghima, this it is an occult power. It makes the mind light, free from the bondages of so many liabilities. This mind, this carefree mind, freed from the fetters of materialistic bondages, can understand and think properly. So, by dint of this occult power, one may understand any idea, subtle or crude, in this realm of abstract. Third one is Mahima, expansion of mind. With the help of positive microvital, mind can be expanded. The radiance of the mind may cover the entire universe, and one may have ideas of different subjects even without going through books and literatures. And one may feel one's oneness with the varieties of this universe. Unity in variety, unity in diversity. Ishitva. It is a sort of occult power. This occult power enables the spiritual aspirant to guide other minds who suffer from so many psychic ailments. Vashitva. This special type of occult power helps a man to bring the defective ideas, or men goaded by defective ideas, onto the path of supreme greatness. Prakamya, right mode of thinking. And this right way of thinking brings newer light to the universe. Prapti. Prapti means helping oneself and helping the souls of so many people to get, to acquire, to be benefited by the grace of the Supreme. And the eighth one is Antaryamita, to be able to enter within the ectoplasmic or endoplasmic structure of others, a sort of transmigration of soul, but not actually transmigration of soul. Regarding this eighth occult power, not only the cult or occult power will suffice, it requires special grace of Paramapurusha also. And there is another occult power. It is also not only an occult power. Here, the positive microvita help the aspirant, but at the same time, there must be devotion, and grace of the Supreme is essential. And above all occult powers, there is the Supreme Knowledge. It is not only a sort of omniscience, but it enables the aspirant to be one with the Supreme Cognitive Faculty. The sadhana starts in the plane of physicality and moves towards the plane of physico-psychic, towards physico-psychic plane. this first phase of sadhana is done by doer-eye. Then from physico-psychic plane to pure psychic plane and pure psychic plane to psycho-spiritual plane, this portion of sadhana is done by knower-eye. And the final stage of sadhana is not the help of microbiome positive or negative. It is the grace of the Supreme. That is, finally you will have to depend on the grace of the Supreme and nothing else. That is, grace is everything. The final word in the realm of spirituality is the Supreme Grace.